Greetings. This is part two in a video series about Deedat's errors thinking Mohammed is the comforter. Deedat confuses the words spirit and prophet. It took me some time to find this particular example from the video.
But we are told it's a spirit. Is Mohammed a spirit? I say yes.
Is Mohammed a spirit? I say yes.
That's what your Bible says.
That's what your Bible says. Actually, this is what Deedat says the Bible says. Or more correctly, this is what Deedat corrupts the Word of God to try and make it say.
You see, every time the word spirit is used in your Bible, I'm telling the Christian, it doesn't stand for the Holy Ghost.
Every time the word spirit is used in the Bible, it does not stand for the Holy Ghost.
Because in the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, we are told that seven spirits of God went out into the world. I said, you believe in seven Holy Ghosts? He says, no, there's only one Holy Ghost. I said, look, it's seven spirits. I mean, it should be seven Holy Ghosts. No, spirit doesn't stand for Holy Ghost every time.
Spirit doesn't stand for Holy Ghost every time. Think about it logically for a moment, and Deedat is correct. In fact, it is not hard to find examples where spirit does not mean the Holy Spirit. Genesis 41:8, and it came to pass in the morning that his spirit was troubled. Here, spirit refers to Pharaoh's spirit. Leviticus 19:31, regard not them that have familiar spirits. Here, spirits refers to familiar spirits, an occult practice. So clearly you can find cases where spirit is used, and it does not mean the holy pneuma.
No, spirit doesn't stand for Holy Ghost every time.
And see now, Deedat has just dropped the holy from the phrase Holy Spirit or Holy Ghost. It is this very subtle kind of crap that Deedat uses to fool every Mohammedan who has no regard for honest and accurate intellectual pursuit of the truth. There are no Bereans in Islam. Let's pause just to recap Deedat's current point. Remember, we are talking about the Comforter. We are reading John 14:26, where Jesus says the Comforter is the holy pneuma, and Deedat is trying to change pneuma into prophet, without you noticing. And Deedat has just dropped the word holy from the text. He now wants to only talk about the spirit, which he will claim means prophet. But let's look closer at John 14:26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, you can see in the text the phrase, the Holy Ghost. The word translated ghost does actually come from the Greek word pneuma. So what word in the Greek causes the word holy to appear in the translated text? The Greek text is agion pneuma, and that may not be a perfect Greek pronunciation. Agion is based on hagios, which means holy or sacred. So while Deedat actually was correct that not every usage of the word spirit means the Holy Spirit, when the word holy is added right before the word spirit, it does absolutely mean the Holy Spirit of God. That's why you add the word holy, because you mean to say holy. That's what Jesus meant when he said Holy Spirit. So Christians, do not be fooled by Deedat's slipshod errors and trickery. When Jesus speaks of the Comforter, and Jesus says the Comforter is the Holy Spirit, Jesus actually used the word holy because he meant to say the Comforter is the Holy Spirit of God. And now we get to the meat of Deedat's poisonous error. Deedat is about to read one verse that he does not understand and base his whole claim on it.
Then in the same John, in the first epistle of John.
But first, just a few notes. The reference Deedat gives is 1 John 5:4, meaning the first epistle of John, chapter 5, verse 4.
Chapter 5, verse 4.
I'm going to point out Deedat does not care enough to get even that much correct. The actual verse he will misunderstand is 1 John 4:1.
He says, "Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, for many false prophets have gone out into the world." So false spirit is a false prophet is a false spirit, true prophet is a true spirit.
1 John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets have gone out into the world. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is of God. And I think you can understand why Deedat is so confused. He sees the word spirit used four times. See here? Believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, then the Spirit of God, and every spirit. He sees the word spirit used four times, and then the word prophet used one time right in the middle. See, he sees the word spirit used these four times, and then he sees the word prophet in the middle.
Saint John is using spirit for a prophet. Don't believe every spirit. Don't believe in every prophet.
And rather than try to understand what this verse really means, Deedat simply sees it as an opportunity to accomplish his goal.
When you talk about spirit, you can have it fitting Muhammad.
Remember, Deedat is not looking to understand the truth of these verses. Deedat's only goal is to try and make credentials for Muhammad. And Deedat is more than willing to twist something he thinks he can make fit Muhammad.
You can have it fitting Muhammad.
Oh, Mohammedan, do you care about the truth? Oh, Mohammedan, do you want to know the truth? Or do you only want to make something fit Muhammad? So here is Deedat's summary that the word spirit and prophet are now suddenly universally interchangeable. And I want you to pay special attention to his stumble. His position and claim is so fragile that even he gets confused how to try and make his claim.
For many false prophets have gone out into the world.
For many false prophets have gone out into the world.
So false spirit is a false prophet is a false spirit. True prophet is a true spirit.
So a false spirit is a false, notice he starts his dramatic finger count. Then his error gets him all confused.
So false spirit is a false prophet is a false spirit. True prophet is a true spirit.
It has to be stated just a certain way or it absolutely makes no sense. Watch his confusion again.
So false spirit is a false prophet is a false spirit. True prophet is a true spirit.
A false prophet is a false spirit. A true prophet is a true spirit.
Saint John is using spirit for a prophet.
Saint John is using spirit for a prophet. I'll pause while you clean the drink you just spewed off of your keyboard. No, John is not using spirit and prophet interchangeably. Deedat confuses the words spirit and prophet. I think that basically demonstrates where Deedat's error comes from as he twists the word of God to try and create credentials for Muhammad as the Comforter, the Holy Spirit of God. Spirit does not mean prophet. Holy Spirit does not mean holy prophet. Remember, this is error number two. Deedat confuses the words spirit and prophet. You can now better understand the flaws in Deedat's erroneous claim. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.